will never stop Frank from getting the slug out of my corruption set from Post Plus. Hello guys, Frank here. Today we're going to be taking a look at Biggus McHugeguy Combination Great Bari Bari Team Epic Model Kit from MODEROID. So this mecha comes from the episode where Pop Team Epic decided to do a parody of Yusha and Brave robots, or Super Giant robots. So basically, they had Obari-san come in and then they made a little special episode. Anyways, this box set contains two things. It contains a box for Super Pipimi, and it contains a box for the super parts for Pipimi-chan. There is a mini Pop-chan, but it's kind of it kind of sucks. I'll show you guys later. It's unpainted and stuff. But anyways, here's the two boxes that you get. There's a Super Pipimi box, the standalone toy, and then there is the super combination box set on the right. So first, taking a look at Super Pipimi, you can see that there is a very good part separation, except for the wrists that don't have the part separation. There are going to be stickers there instead, and then the chest also has stickers to part separate. But other than that, it looks pretty spot on to the anime. And then there's also another color correction on the feet that are going to be part separated with stickers, but I threw away the stickers because I don't like the stickers for the feet. And then this duct is supposed to be red, but you don't get the parts to make it red. It's just blue. But anyways, other than that, it looks pretty nice. The colors are spot on to the anime, and pretty much it's a very good representation of Pipimi. The posability is very nice. It's pretty standard actually, but the double jointed knees, and then it has a single jointed arm, but the arm is actually like it's not that posable, but you can make it do with it because it's like you're not gonna be putting this thing in poses that are requiring too many arm joints. I don't think it just needs to hold up the sword and that's it, and the cannons. But yeah, this is a very nice little figure of Super Pipimi. And if I were to do a size comparison, the high resolution Red Freya Stream, which is going to be 1/100th or MG size, and then there's going to be the Yagdoga, which is going to be 1/144th HG size. So moving on to the accessories for the base Super Pipimi form, we have 4 hands, 2 pairs of hands, and then they're used for grabbing these swords on the top. And if you can see, there is going to be holes in the hands to grab the swords very nicely, and then there's a splayed open hands. And then you get a spare face. This is actually a different mold. It has the open mask, and this face is actually going to be used in the anime for a different form when Super Pipimi attacks the antagonist in the first scene. And then there's no face mask to it. And then you also get another figurine. It's not painted, but if you paint it, you have a nice figure of Pop-chan. It's really nice. I like the sculpted details on it. And I wish I had enough painting skills to paint that thing as well.
And now here's what you get with the box too. So you get basically this is an original form, but this is basically all the stuff that makes the Pipimi super mode. And here is the unpainted. Basically this is the Pop-chan, and she's really cute. If it can focus, she's pretty cute, and she can turn into like a little her face actually has to come off for the super transformation mode. So it's really weird. There's a lot of parts forming in this super combination, and you get 4 pairs of hands. You get 2 pairs of hands to side lock the like hold the cannon by the side, and then I'll show you that later. And then there is the main that goes on the chest of Pop-chan, and then there's the extended shoulder parts which go on Pop-chan's shoulders. It has a very nice clear green inside, and there is the super rocket pods that's going to be in the shitty manga drive super mode function. And there's a rocket missile pods, and then it's pretty nice. It looks pretty good. And then there is the waste rocket launcher that comes out in Pop's super mode. And then this is a sticker, color correcting sticker. So just be warned of that. And then there is finally the super mode head. The super mode head only comes with this face mask, and yeah, it's pretty good. Super Pipimi into super great mode, you're going to need these parts right here. And then basically you come up to the back and you take off this cape right here, and then you add this cape right here like that to the back, like so. Oh, it has a little bit of a click, and then you're gonna just add the cape back, and then he has wings. And then you see now there's two shoulders. So we're actually gonna use the big transformation shoulder. So we have to take off these shoulders. If I can just pop out the shoulder. So the shoulders are on, and then basically moves this to there, and then we're gonna put the legs on. To put the legs, simply just pull on this one and then take a leg and make sure the thrusters are facing the outside. And then we're going to line this up to the leg, and then we're just gonna push it in. Just gonna push in the legs. Very nice. Then make sure that it's set back again from the dragon form, so it has a nice leg right there. Transformation to Great Pipimi is almost done. We're going to just need Papu's face, and then we're just going to pop it off. Just going to pop it off. And then we have to put it onto this piece right here. Then we're going to pop her face on right there. Like this. Perfect. And then we have to put on the head. And then it's going to make Super Pipimi. So I'm going to do the head first. Just put on the head. The new head sculpt looks like this. Very cool. And then we're going to put on the head. So the head's being put on, and then we're going to put on the chest piece now. And then the chest piece, you just basically unplug this one, and then there's going to be a tab in the back that leads to there. And you just tab it in like that. And then you have Super Pipimi. Looks pretty cool. And then you have clear parts there. You have the big shoulders there, you have clear parts here in the leg, and yeah, it looks pretty good. And then now Super Pipimi has these parts for the shitty manga drive full blast attack. So first of all, we're going to get these missile pods onto the shoulders right here. We're just going to pop off the wing like that. And then it just slides in like so. It just slides in there, and then so we have the missile pods on the both shoulders like that. And then we're going to take the waist cannon right here. The waist cannon, it's just gonna go straight into his wing like this. Down there. It's just gonna pop in like that. And then these guys just lock in there. There's nowhere for them to go, so it's kind of weird. It just feeds into the backpack like that. There's nowhere. It's just a bunch of hoses like that. So this just goes in there like that. and then this goes back into Super Papimi. This. And then finally, Super Papimi can do the. Can get this. If I can find the freaking angle to put. Yeah, there you go. And then she has the great manga cannon. She can hold it on her own weight like this. Like that. But the thing is, it doesn't have the side, like, buster cannon. It only has one entrance, and that is this one-handed. So she can only hold it one-handed, but it's fine. It's not that bad. Like, she can even, like, hold it up like that, and then it still has stability.
So this kit, the Biggus McHugeguy combination, Bari Bari Team Epic, I would give 8 out of 10. It's really nice, but I think it has too much parts combination for me.
の蓄えた力が最強コンテンツの売り上げが抜けていく。キングレコーダー、お前の予算エネルギーは私たちのクソ漫画ドライブに吸収され、オーバリッドエネルギーへと変換される。これで終わりだ。グレードクソキャノン、フル